Thanks for joining us in Business as we feature people, ideas and companies that move financial markets. You're in business with me, Harsha Subramaniam. This is on top of our agenda. We talk economy with Indranil Pan, Chief Economist at Kotak Mahindra Bank. We put the spotlight on the landmark patent case involving Novartis with Vikas Dandekar, India Bureau Chief at PharmAsia News, and a special conversation with Wilbur Ross. But first, hot stocks with Surbhi.
Harsha, morning. It's not such a bad morning, actually. Looking at what's happening across the health of the Asian region, 5710 on the Nifty, a 0.5% gain. We're taking steady steps up. Look at the Japanese market. It's really sulking after some negative data, 1% down there. The South Korean exports not really very hot, so the South Korean market is lower. So relative outperformance for us here. What is leading to this outperformance? Quite a bit of so-called high beta stocks or more volatile stocks. So the likes of the DLF surging 4.5%, Reliance Infra and BHEL from the infra space, a JP Associates, even a Kane India managing a rebound of around 2%. What is weak today, however, are a couple of auto names. Tata Motors stands out in that list. 2% down. We're not expecting a great month of March for most of these auto companies. They're under a little bit of stress. The talk of the market obviously has to be Novartis and what will come out of the Supreme Court. This is Novartis India, the listed entity. It's trading right now down about 2%. Most of the Indian pharma companies are actually trading up for whatever it's worth. Not all of them stand to be directly impacted by the ruling, but the sentiment is positive across pharma. Cipla 0.5% up. Natco Pharma and Reddy's sitting on gains of about 2-3% as we await details from the Supreme Court. Some more stocks in focus, Sterlite and Cessa Goa, a negative ruling coming in from the courts. As far as Sterlite's Tuticorin smelter is concerned, the copper smelter, that has to be shut down as the case is going on, and a negative fallout on both the stocks of the Vedanta Group for now. That's the market. Harsha, back to you.
Surbhi, thank you so much for that. We put the spotlight on that pharma case. The Supreme Court will deliver its verdict on that landmark patent case involving Novartis. The pharma company has led what has been a 7-year-long legal battle demanding patent protection for its cancer drug, Glivec. Vikas Dandekar now joins us. Vikas is the Bureau Chief at PharmAsia News. Vikas, thank you so much for joining in. This is not just another patent case. This perhaps may set the precedent for battles of patent, non-patent from here on. Explain to us why you think this is significant.
Right. So, as you rightly defined it, it's a far-reaching impact that the Supreme Court decision will have, and it is definitely not an ordinary patent case. It's been going on from 1998, from the time Novartis actually put in its first exclusive marketing rights for the drug. That was even before the 2005 amended Patent Act came into effect. What Novartis is actually arguing here is that, you know, it's product has been patented in 40 countries, and it has enhanced effect, which is being countered vehemently by all the Indian generic companies led by Ranbaxy, Hetero, Natco, Cipla, and also Cancer Patients Aid Association. The debate here is on the validity of Section 3D. Now, what Section 3D says is actually what is not patentable. And in several of its arguments and discussions, Novartis has actually gone to the extent of saying that it has proven bioavailability, increased bioavailability as compared to its base compound, which was patented back in 1993. So, in case this decision goes in favor of Novartis, it will be a massive, massive victory for global companies, which have been arguing that incremental innovations do come under the ambit of patents, and they put forth all the reasons of patents that are kind of given to their companies in US and even in Europe.
Sure.
On the other side are generic companies, which definitely are not in sync with the global thinking. And feel that several of the frivolous patents have been getting evergreening.
Sure.
And that's what the Supreme Court will have to decide today.
Because that's exactly the point I was coming to. On one hand, this judgment may perhaps limit India's patenting genuine new drugs or what is now being called evergreening, or just amending earlier versions of the drug, and whether that can be patented at all. Let's put that point aside. What does this mean for domestic generic companies? Because we have seen several reports of foreign majors saying that Indian companies are abusing their position, abusing international law, and will this case or the verdict of this case, in a sense, put to rest such speculation?
Right. So there has been a raging international debate regarding how effective is Indian patent law. While obviously the generic companies have held up that the Indian patent laws are stringent and have set very high standards to get through the patenting procedures. While on the other side, global companies have been saying that it's not in rhythm with the TRIPS which has been signed by India, and it doesn't go with the international norms.
I'll have to interrupt you right there. News just flashing across your screen right now. The Supreme Court has denied, if I'm told correct, has denied permission to Novartis getting that patent. Let's await for the news flash to come across your screen before we take this conversation forward. That's the word coming from the Supreme Court. It denies cancer drug patent to Novartis. This is significant. This is the breaking news on your screen at this point. The Supreme Court has denied Novartis patent to this cancer drug Glivec. The debate has been about whether Novartis will be able to get this patent and the implications thereof that it will have across different countries. Remember, Novartis has patented this drug in 40 countries across the world. Vikas, quick reaction before I get some more details from the court.
This is pretty much on expected lines. Last week when Dr. Paul Herling of Novartis spoke to us a few from the media, he did mention this as the first likelihood that there will be an outright denial of the patent, and so it probably goes in sync and in line with what the other courts have actually done with so many other patents sought by global companies. A huge victory here for generic companies, and so all the fears about the availability of the drug and how things will move on the generic side is put to rest for now.
Does this, in a sense, Vikas, uphold the current position of the patent law as understood and perceived by the Indian pharma industry and the regulatory environment?
Absolutely. This is exactly what was expected. Now it depends on the fine print whether there is any clause that is needed to revisit Section 3D. I don't think there will be a need, because if the hearings are already over and the verdict is out, firmly denying a patent to Novartis, it is actually a validation of what is laid in the Section 3D of the Indian Patents Act. So it's probably reached a final culmination here.
Does this open the door for many more cases of this nature, specifically that might benefit the domestic generic pharma industry?
It will, in fact, definitely. In fact, one very burning example is of Glenmark, which has actually launched a version of Januvia. Even when the patent of sitagliptin, which belongs to Merck, is in force in India. So that is, again, a validation of what is going on in the Indian patent scenario. You know, from the global company side, I think there will be a massive criticism of what has actually been pronounced. Right now, they have been threatening that some of the launches may be held back, and it is definitely a weak signal for future investments of global generic companies into India.
What does this verdict mean as far as the Indian patient is concerned, the guys who really need the healthcare is concerned? Because I'm asking you in the context of what the government has been saying so far, that affordable drugs have the key objective of their entire policy. In a sense, will poor Indian patients will they get these drugs at affordable cost? Because the differential in price is almost 10 times.
Oh, it's a very, very, very valid question, Harsha, because, you know, we have seen that in case of anti-cancer drugs, global companies do have in place patient access programs wherein they say that, you know, the ones which are actually needing those drugs and are not reimbursed or not under any insurance, they are put under patient access programs. But those are very far and few, and probably there will need to be a new thinking from global companies on how more can drugs get cheaper. Because there is a very firm alternative that Indian government does have, and that is of compulsory license. We've heard again and again that not just communicable diseases, the government may not hesitate to put compulsory license in terms of non-communicable communicable diseases also. So it just doesn't stop at HIV or cancer. It might go up to, you know, any other product which require a government intervention where affordability and access is compromised.
Sure. Because just hang in there, I have just one more question for you. But before that, if you've just tuned in, the Supreme Court has denied patent for its cancer drug to Novartis as far as Glivec is concerned. More importantly, it is rubbing salt into its wounds because it's not just denied the patent to Novartis, the Supreme Court has also imposed a cost on Novartis for filing the case. That's the breaking news at this point. The Supreme Court has denied the patent for Novartis as far as the cancer drug is concerned, that is Glivec. It has also imposed a cost on Novartis for filing this case. That's the latest from the Supreme Court. We also have Sarabjit Kaur Nangra from Vice President Research joining in on the phone line from Angel Broking. Sarabjit, many thanks for joining in. How do you see this? How do you read this case? What does this mean for domestic pharma stocks, rather?
See, clearly from a multinational company's perspective, it's a negative because Novartis has been, trying to fight this case for pretty long. So the battle has been wrong for pretty long and finally they have lost the case. So for any multinational company, I don't think any multinational company will take it as a precedent, but yeah, it will be a negative for the companies who are trying to launch new products, but it will depend from case to case. And I think most of the MNC companies like Glaxo, Aventis, they are looking forward to launching new products in India. So I think it's just one of the cases. Probably it will not deter most of the companies from launching, but yeah, in a short term, it kind of tends to give a negative signal.
No, but what my question to you was really about, what does this mean for domestic pharma companies, especially the guys who are largely based on a generic model? Do you believe that there is a case for investing in these stocks?
Most of these Indian companies are into exports. So they are deriving majority of their revenues to exports. Even if I look from an industry perspective, more than 50% of the revenues are export-oriented rather than domestic-oriented.
Sure.
So to that extent, and as you are aware that most of the drugs globally are going towards generics. Generics is gaining a predominance in the overall pie. Patent products are reducing in terms of their share in the overall. And that's the reason you're seeing that most of the countries are promoting generics. So from a long-term perspective, and most of the products, are me too kind of products. So to that extent, it doesn't shake the dynamics of domestic pharma industry.
Sarabjit, many thanks for joining us with your perspective. Last word, Vikas, where does Novartis go from here? Is there a possibility you would think that this will perhaps apply for a review petition? Or do you think this is cut your losses and move home?
Actually, that's something that the world will be watching for, on how Novartis wants to take this forward. To me, I think it's a decisive blow to Novartis, and it seals a long litigation in the final verdict. So far as Novartis itself is concerned, agreeing partly with Sarabjit that companies will keep launching their products, what will probably be done is to revisit the pricing dynamics and market access dynamics, because if India has to be accessed and approached from the market perspective, it will have to be done in a very, very systematic manner and something that suits the Indian conditions.
Vikas Dandekar, many thanks for joining us with your perspective. That was Vikas Dandekar from Asia News with his views on this landmark judgment from the Supreme Court as far as Novartis is concerned. Supreme Court has denied the patent for its cancer drug for Novartis, that is Glivec. It's not only done that, it's also imposed a cost on Novartis for filing the case. We now have Agam, a research analyst, also joining in on this conversation. Agam, when you spoke to analysts, what is the sense that you get? I mean, from a purely domestic pharma stock point of view, what does this mean for the generic industry? What does this mean for the pharma, multinational pharma stocks as well?
Well, the battle clearly here was between the big pharma companies and, the patent protection, thus their investments, as against the smaller pharma companies, which were allowed to continue with their cheaper, generic versions.
Sure.
And based on that, this clearly is a victory when it comes to the smaller pharma companies, which were allowed with their generic versions.
Yes.
And now, what we are talking about here is the fact that As the Supreme Court has held that this particular drug is not a novelty, it is not patentable under the Patents Act, and further, the fact that it's an existing compound, we do not have, on that basis, they've actually rejected the fact that it can be patented for now.
Is it too early for the street to take a call on which side of the pharma industry that they're willing to put their money on?
Yes, but as of now, you already have positive reactions on stocks like pharma, like Cipla, Natco Pharma, as well as Glenmark Pharma. On the other hand, you're seeing a huge knock when it comes to Novartis. So at least as far as sentiment goes, or the understanding of, the latest understanding of what the situation is, it's very much, reflecting the stock's reactions right now.
All right, let's wait and watch what happens to the domestic pharma industry. And what this really means for earnings and the road ahead for some of these companies, clearly it's a negative as far as Novartis is concerned. We don't know yet if there is going to be a review petition. We're slipping a break in business right now. We'll continue our coverage on what the Supreme Court verdict means, but we also talk about the macroeconomy. Current account deficit, remember, came at a record high. Implications with Indraneel Pan, Chief Economist at Kotak Mahindra Bank. Back in business in 2 minutes.